I will be showing you what we will have to do to make your white plates since you notified us that you want to make the pineapple itself shiny, which means the rest will need to be white. So what we're going to do is delete all of these layers out of here. We are going to take the magic wand. Settings are at point sample, tolerance of 32. You want to actually select the background so that all of these areas, you can see the edge here, actually is selected. We want to go select, we want to go modify, and because we have the basically the background selected, we want to actually expand this particular path. We want to go 1 pixel. So you'll notice that, uh-oh, that it came in so that you have color on the outside. Now what we want to do is we want to create a new layer, and we want to, let me check what this build is. Just for the sake of, oops, some serious saturation. For when I do my next step, I want it to make it a rich black. So I'm going to go option delete. As you can see, now this is black. And I will delete this. So now that I have a really rich black, I'm going to go image mode grayscale. Oh shoot, I have to check your size. I need to make your size, your canvas size. I'm just going to make it 0.25 larger on both sides because I don't know what your size is and I want to make sure you have bleed. So let's actually go back because I want to make sure that that black ends up being this, the right color. I'm going to deselect image, canvas size, 0.25 or 0.25 larger. Now when I make it, it will be the right size plus bleed. You always have to make sure the background has bleed. So now I'm going to go back. We're going to select the background. We're going to go select, modify. We want to expand by 1 pixel. We want to create a new layer. We want to check our values. The values are fine for the black, all 100. I'm going to go with the background selected still, option delete. Now that I have that done, I can delete this. And I can deselect. I'm going to go image mode grayscale. Yes, I want to discard color information. I'm going to go file save as. I'm going to name this white plate. So that the original file is not overwritten. Click OK. Now that this is a grayscale, it can be colored inside Illustrator. I have opened up with layers your file inside Illustrator versus flat, which we normally do when we get a file. If we get errors, so I have to deselect everything. And I have to create outlines, which would be type. And if they were still, here, I'll do it. Type, and you would create outlines this way. What this does is keeps the fonts as shapes and not live text. So if someone doesn't have your fonts, they will not default. So I'm gonna do that. Now I'm gonna take the white plate that we made, bring it over here. And I'm going to just center it so that you can see it lands perfectly where it needs to. I am going to put this on overprint. And I'm also going to put the transparency on darken. What you will notice is that now it probably could be 2 pixels because I see how on this top end it's a little off. But it's centered on some. What this did was it made the white plate, which is black, actually trap into the color. So they may leave it as one, they may make it 2 points, but this is what you'll need to do for all of the labels that you want to be backed by white in this shiny for this matter. So what we would actually do here is make it a white fill. And not a white fill, but a white ink swatch we have, we fill it with that. And then we do this to show customer service that we actually want it on clear. I'm going to take that, put that, and put it on its own layer, and name that layer white ink. So now, but here's the problem. Somewhere you have a white, okay? Okay, that is just that. Okay, so I'm going to turn on my white layer. We'll move a copy over to the side for them to have. I'm going to take it off of darken so that they can see that's what the white plate looks like. Go ahead and take this one off because I don't want that solid white to be existing and someone not see it. So I'm just going to move this down just for the sake of your proof. That way they will see the white plate. So that's how we create the white plate. You could do this before sending it to us, it'll be great. If not, depending on how many items they'll assist, what the additional fee would be to create your white plate. If you have any additional questions, please be sure to contact our customer service rep, and they will be able to get you the information. Oh, let me check the blocks while I'm recording. All the blocks need to be black only, and as you can see, this is a rich black. So we would need to go view, select, sorry, select same fill color. And we would have to change all of these to black only because they're not the same fill. They're going to all look differently. So you want to make sure all of your blacks are the correct fill. They have to be the same fill in order to print the same color. So when you turn off black, no longer see black except for this rich black in here. If you want to go into Photoshop and make that black only, you can choose to do that. Otherwise, this is how you make a black plate. This is how you check for your black to make sure it is the correct fill, that they will all look the same. And once again, if you have any questions, please contact customer